morning. I'm Adi, and this is an exclusive feature, and this will be the first podcast ever on the forum. So I hope you enjoy and be with us through the entire session. And before going further, I'd like to introduce one of the leading ladies, a woman entrepreneur, the founder president of Optivista, a counselor, and a beautiful and amazing teacher, Ms. Tribenee Bhattacharyya. Please, ma'am, thank you so much, and welcome to East Splits. So, before going on any further, I'd like to know, how all of this started, the Optivista. Was it always on your mind that you wanted to be a teacher, you wanted to be a counselor, or that sort, or it something happened randomly?
Okay, so I would say it happened randomly, actually. So I am basically from agriculture background, so I was there in Johan Agriculture, some agriculture university. I got an opportunity to Erasmus Mundus, to do my further studies in Spain. When I went there, I thought I saw different kind of things out there. It was very positive. And positive in terms of education system, learning system, and teacher-student relationship is very different. So that is where it got ignited. So after coming back, I thought that I should take certain kind of initiatives which will help our students, basically our students and upcoming generation to grow. And what I found is that the main root is a teacher. So if teachers can build a healthy relationship with the students some way or the other, they come up in a very brighter way. So I thought, why not me? I thought of inculcating certain kinds of habits within myself. And somehow or other, I focus on building good relationship with the teacher, with the students, and apart from them, motivating them. So, and then I started taking interest in the neuro-linguistic programming part, which is completely a form of a study pattern. It's a study of language of the neurons. And now I am a certified trainer of neuro-linguistic programming psychotherapist. And at present, I am running this sessions in Optivista, which is my own venture, which has been started 4 years back. And successfully, I am continuing with this. Previously, I started as a trainer. And then with that, from here, this Optivista learning hub is taking various initiatives specifically to uplift the teenagers, uplift the young minds, and not only with the young generation, but at the same time motivating the elderly people. Say, for example, we do conduct trainings on managing workplace stress to we deliver trainings to people in various departments and targeting age group of around 60-65, because why not they? Like teenagers, okay, with the age, they are very motivating and full of energy. But that age group, okay, they go down for no reason. Like there's certain kind of reasons. So as a whole, so this is a completely project that I have taken up to uplift different age groups mentally, so that I can help them, help in boosting up the energies in a positive and channelizing the energies in a better way. So that is overall objective of Optivista, and we are running it successfully. Our team is doing it till date, so it's continuing.
So you said you went back to Spain have the studies somehow. You got an opportunity. It was different back then.
Yeah.
The relationship with the students and the teachers, they're more of like friends, because
yes,
we see it in the
exactly.
Most of the movies.
Uh-huh.
But here it is kind of different.
Uh-huh.
But yes, that is our culture, it's our heritage, we have to preserve it. But yes, what you said was absolutely right. If we take a step forward in creating such kind of relationships between the students and the teachers, I think better people will come out.
Exactly, very true. Somehow or the future of the student depends upon the teacher.
Yes.
So maybe train their minds,
exactly.
The young minds.
And talking about young minds, as you know, the exams are around the corner, and I have seen my parents what are they doing? It's 4 in the morning, we're still sleeping. So we have gone through that phase, but now technology has made this advancement, has changed. Now you can just open up YouTube and all the lessons are there. So what like during the exam session, because people take a lot of stress.
Yes.
There's physical stress and the mental stress. And the parents, I will not tell in general, but yes, there is a certain pressure upon the parents as well. Because it is not the child who is giving the exam, it is the parents
who are giving the exam.
Oh, my God. So, what, how to deal with such kind of pressure?
Okay, so let me tell you, some way or the other that this comes at the parenting skills. Now, the parents get so pressurized because the student's exam is coming. Because of that, they for no reason, they make their child worry. Okay, exam is coming, and that is an extra bonus fear they give to their children. So, they transmit that fear to their children. But the first thing I would like to, this is my advice to the parents, that just relax. It is just an exam. And somewhere or the other, if they fail in that exam, which is not going to happen, but somewhere or the other, if something goes wrong, even though in the exam, that is completely fine. Because, see, what I suggest is that parents should give more emphasis in more emphasis in the mental health of a child. He should learn. A student should not be graded according to the marks that he is getting in the exams. So why we boast around like my child is getting 100%, he is getting 90%. Whereas what about the other parents, rest of the parents, or rest of the children? So we should not create that differentiation. That is where it begins. If your child gets 90%, that is fine. If not, then also it is fine, because nothing is going to change. And somewhere or the other, what we should understand, that as a child, when the child is growing, he also has a certain kind of space. We need to give them a space, and he will take the stress, he will take the necessary kind of responsibilities according to his capacity. If we overburden him, if we give him more responsibilities than required, and somewhere or the other, the things gets collapsed, the child goes out of our hand. So we need to, this is a very sophisticated kind of matter. Yeah, and every parent should understand the importance of understanding the emotional well-being of a child. Because a child is growing, at the same time we understand being an adult, we think that like, oh my God, he should get a job, he should get this, if not, then what will happen? We have got so many queries, but at the same time we have to think about the stage of our child. We have to think the capacity that he can, the load that he can take. So I do suggest, parents, you do not have to worry. Let your child grow. Let your child learn. Let's focus on learning things instead of focusing on the marks that they are getting. So learning and getting knowledge is much more important. We need to give emphasis on it. And it doesn't mean that one who is knowledgeable will get more marks. Right. One who is more knowledgeable might not get the highest mark. That is fine. But we need to give learning as a step-by-step process, and not only with the parents, I need to say with the teachers as well. They need to give more focus on the learning, how they are learning, whether they are able to capture and gather things in a proper way, and then applying it in a field. Uh-huh, exactly.
Yes. Do you think that whenever the stress and all comes, because the parents also, as you have already told, because the moment an exam comes, there will be phone calls of the relatives pouring in. Now, do you think that this is one of the reasons why the students are going through that kind of rebellious phase, and like they are recused from their parents, they don't intend to sit with them, have a talk with them, what's happening with them? Do you think this is also affecting their relationships with the parents as well?
Yes, very true. Because somehow or the other, we give more, we have the fear of judgment of the society. Right, we do not come up the way we are. Why? Because we have the fear of the judgment of the society, and we have the fear, oh my God, my neighbor's child got this much of marks, my relative, this is my child is not getting that much. But it is completely fine. What I say is that, see, this kind of stresses will definitely come, right, because somewhere or another. But what I believe is that have faith on your child. Because child and mother, as well as the father, they should have a good connectivity. Once we need to understand that the growth of the emotional growth is very, very necessary. The stressor that you get from the surroundings should not be transmitted to your child, because he doesn't know what is happening, or he is not aware about the environment. So what we need to take is that the first thing we need to decide is such kind of fears or such kind of things are happening, even with the parents also, just sit peacefully and patiently. and have faith on your student, because have faith on your children, because it is you who know your child better. And somehow or the other, I always tell the best psychotherapist can judgment. And another thing, here I would also say that the exam fear, whatever they get or the stress they get, is not only because of the parents' expectations. Parents, they have got a different level of expectations, and apart from the teachers also have a different kind of expectations, right? So that expectations, it is not necessary, we should not pressurize them with that. Some way or the other, we should let the child grow, as I have already mentioned it, right? So that is what, and if something, and some way or the other, the child might show certain kind of tantrums, emotional tantrums. They might show, he might show. So at that time, we need to sit and talk to the child in a proper way during the time of examination, before the time of examination. We need to make clear what clutters are there in his head.
So as of her, the expert opinion, don't stress out your child because he is already stressed out. So it is better to have a talk with your child, whatever happens, you go with him or with her, always. Because I personally believe that one single piece of paper, he cannot judge the future.
Exactly.
Knowledge is inside.
Exactly.
So that's the one thing you will take away when you die.
Exactly.
Others, they will be that way.
Exactly.
So, moreover, when these stresses and all come, there is also a certain change in the personality too. Person of the individual.
Yeah, exactly.
He tends to become someone he or she is not.
Yeah, exactly.
So, how do you think that, is it so important for an individual to be physically sound and maintain the discipline and the personality that he has or she has and develop it into something new? Is it necessary?
Yeah. Exactly. So see, if we talk about the children or the teenagers or college going students, they will say that, oh my god, my exams are coming. So either they do emotional eating, right? They do emotional eating. What is the reason? Stress, right? Or whether they go for smoking, getting into junk foods and all. Because why? What is the reason? Stress, right? So exam stress. So, somewhere or the other, what I do believe is that before giving them bookish knowledge, we should emphasize more on tuning the biological clock of a student. So, what I think every college should take this initiative and they give emphasis on happiness of a child, happiness of a children, and give emphasis to the alignment of a student, like biological alignment or biological clock. Say for example, as you have said, most of the time when I interact with the students, I find that they are not at all aligned within themselves. They get up at 10 and they get up at 8. If they have college, they get up at 6 and they do not know. They do not eat. And in the evening, they think, why this is happening? The first thing we need to remember is that we should know how to align, how to give emphasis to our biological clock. Now, when I say biological clock, when we say discipline comes only with the tuning of the biological clock. So, everywhere it is said that we need to have a timetable, because mental health doesn't come all of a sudden. Now, during exams, what we do is that we stress the nights, right? Late night studies, I know that students are very expert in it, and they emphasize, okay, I passed the exams, and it is okay, done. And rest of the days, it is like, oh my god, let me sleep, right? Or let me, freak out, and then these things happen. So what I suggest is that, my dear students, it is not with the marks. What I suggest, please get aligned with your biological clock. Get up on time, get up timely, and sleep on proper time. Now, what happens when these things happen automatically and during the exam, not only during the exam, every day I suggest each and every student should go for certain kind of physical activities, because physical activity is directly related to the stress. More you do physical activities, your stress hormone, that is cortisol hormone, releases. It goes down. And basically, I do suggest students, if you have exam, go up for an outing. Even 15 minutes or half an hour outing on it also will relax, will make you feel relaxed. That is the first point. And second point is that with your eating habits, we need to monitor, because mindset is directly related to your eating habits. Okay. If we think healthy, if we are emotionally tuned, we always choose to eat something healthy, not the unhealthy foods. And last but not the least, the most important point that I would like to emphasize, and basically I do provide training on this, this is like EFT, that is called emotional freedom technique. Okay, emotional freedom technique. Now, what emotional freedom technique is all about? Say, for example, a student, say if I say maths, most of the students know my word maths. They automatically will have interference and the other. In my period also, I got my math teacher was the most, no, my god, annoying kind of thing. So, because of that, as you have mentioned, when the personality changes. Now, to stop, to restrict the change in the personality, personality is all about how we react towards our atmosphere, towards our situations. Okay. So, somewhere or the other, what happens is that to stop, but the personality part, I would just like to say that so that it doesn't get drift apart, I would say EFT technique is the most important one. Now, what is EFT? Emotional freedom technique. This should be practiced before examination. This should be practiced in the examination hall by the teachers as well as before going to bed by the students. Now, what exactly this is all about? Say, for example, you have got maths exam, right? You have a fear.
Super
freaked out. Yeah. And then, yeah, what you need to do is that you sit calmly. Okay, do not sit with your friends. Oh my god, now I'm going to do EFT. No, nothing like that. You sit calmly, and then what you do? You just tap your hands here. Say four positive quotations with that feelings. Okay. Say, for example, I have my maths examination. It's fine. Things will be go okay. I have maths examination. Yeah, fear is there, but I know how to deal with this fear. I have maths examination, but okay, I'm completely relaxed now. Okay, when you say quotation, and then what you do, you need to tap certain kind of points where you get the stress. Say, for example, here. Okay, here. You get the fear here. I'm getting the fear, but it's completely now I'm getting relaxed as I'm tapping it here. I'm getting the fear here. Okay, the stress that I'm getting is completely dissolving. I'm getting the fear here in the collarbones part, right? And yeah, it is dissolving. Slowly and slowly it is dissolving. And somewhere or the other, we get the fear in the stomach as well. Oh my god, this is okay. Like slowly and slowly. You just need to feel it. That is called emotional freedom technique. Emotional freedom technique. And you can also tap in the sides of your arms. Sides of your arms. You just tap in here. And then okay, my fear is dissolving. Because most of the time when we say fear or when we say stress, we feel in the upper part of our body. Right? So, and then when we say that with a positive quotation, when we say and say, some way or the other, we get that power from within, that things are relaxing. And after doing that particular part, what we need to do is that we stretch our hand and hold it in a proper way, and then we breathe. Your requirement, you can twist it. Yeah, the first thing is that when you do this, we need to feel it. Next, when we do this, we need to imagine ourselves getting relaxed. Yeah.
So it is kind of giving yourself positive affirmations.
Positive affirmations, exactly.
So, whatever happens, it happens for a reason, and
exactly.
Nothing to worry about, everything will turn out to be good.
Exactly, so, yeah. Or you are feeling comfortable with the things that is there inside you. That is fine. You are having a butterfly in the soup, but you are feeling comfortable with the things that is there. It is necessary. That means you are building the relationship with the emotions that you are going through.
Okay.
Right. Healthy relationship.
Healthy relationships.
Yeah.
If you have a healthy relationship with the mind and you can control it,
yeah,
then everything is going to be fine. There is nothing to worry about.
Yeah, exactly.
So, another expert opinion on this. Very twisted topic, I would say, because it is very, like, general people don't get it, what is happening, because they don't understand what is happening.
Exactly.
So, I would personally say this, that whatever ma'am has said, it is very true, and you should definitely give yourself some positive information in the morning, and before going to bed, that, okay, I had a great day, the next day I will be a better man. So everything will turn out to be good.
Yeah, exactly. And the most important part is you need to recognize your stressors. Because your stress might be different and my stress might be different.
Yes.
Right, and accordingly, I need to be aware about my emotions that's going on in my head. Right, that is necessary.
Then, you have been a teacher, by the way, the viewers, I think they don't know. I was one of the fortunate few to have her as my teacher back in my engineering days. So, you have been a teacher, a counselor, and recently I've gone to know a psychotherapist as well. So, you have been playing so many different roles. So, was it difficult for you to maintain all the roles separately, or you have like come up with a way of like binding them together and establishing your own different personality?
See, something or the other, what I do believe is that knowledge is a different part, going and getting myself trained up is a different part, and applying it to myself is a different part. Right, whatever we take, training the first thing, we need to do that, because we cannot preach unless we do it in ourselves. So it is a completely a transition state for me. When I was a beginner, after I did all my studies, I totally emphasized completely 6 months on applying it in myself. When I applied completely the theories and everything in myself, I said, oh my god, so many changes happens within yourself. And you literally feel that and the calmness that you get it. So somehow or the other, it was not difficult, because whatever I am saying, whatever I am training, it is there within me, and I can see the changes that has happened to me. So it is like with my life, I am continuing it in the same way. The roots are almost same, even the branches are there. The roots are same, everybody, everything. And somehow or another, what I believe is that if I do have a healthy relationship with myself, I can definitely give some radiant positive vibes to others, and that relationship goes in a very healthy way. So yeah, application part, I give much emphasis before preaching. I give emphasis to applying myself.
And on top of that, I have been hearing certain news, which is on social media or in general. I have a next door neighbor too. So, and this is a question from one of our members. So, it is very common nowadays that the youngsters, the youths, they are getting into a lot of heartbreaks. Most of them, they will like go on the late night thing that you say, super TikTok. It actually normally happens in exams, but it also happens in relationships too. The new relationships that are coming. They get into a lot of heartbreaks and all because of one thing or other, because they're not compatible or something. But some individuals, they take some drastic steps. So how to control that kind of situation, or what would you advise if a certain person is going through a heartbreak or a traumatic experience? What would you suggest such a person? What would be your advice?
It is very necessary for me, like from my viewpoint, or literally what exactly is getting into a relationship is all about. Getting into a relationship is not la la la. Okay, you just go and jump into it, and then like you get gifts.
Maximum time happens. A boy likes a girl, the girl likes a boy, and they think, okay, we can stay together the whole time. But that's not the thing, because many a times I have come across a term called infatuation.
Exactly.
There's a fine line between life, love, and infatuation. People need to understand that.
Exactly. Very true. People need to understand that, and some or the other, what I have seen with the teenagers is that teenagers are getting into falling into love, and they are very quick. I mean, they get into the bed and they have all the bed funds and all, and after some time, everything has got collapsed. So what I suggest to everyone is that before you fall for something, remember, so that is why it is said we fall in love, we never rise in love. We rise in love too, so to rise in love, the relationship should be very healthy. At first, what I suggest is that love is equals to responsibility. We need to understand love is not about giving sweets to somebody or giving flowers to somebody or saying I love you 1,000 times in the night and in the morning you get up and then like start with a conflict. No, it is all about taking responsibility of their happiness, of each other's happiness. The first thing is that now taking responsibility of each other's happiness is somehow or the other difficult. What I suggest is that each one of offshoot, yeah, you must fall in love, because while we fall in love, we learn many things, right? Because I have seen while giving a counseling, right, my parents come and says that like my child has fallen in love with a girl. Now I'm very upset. Then I say, you don't have to. I can see after you, he fell in love. With the smoking part, he is no more into smoking now. He's no more into alcohol. Yeah, right?
Exactly.
This is what I like. Yeah, with the grooming part also, he has started taking. Yes. That is a positive part as well. I mean, this is a very beautiful journey. But what I suggest is that you need to be cautious of it. So yeah, if you find certain kind of things are not going well with a relationship and something or other you broke up, remember that breaking up period is a very, it depends upon you now, how you are using it, how you are channelizing your energy. Something or other, few students, what they do, the three consequences are there what I have seen. The first thing is that one will say, chalo break up ho gaya, let's get into some other new relationship, right? So, and then second, what they will do is that, oh my God, I broke up with her. Anyways, I will uplift myself. I will uplift myself and channelize my energy in a different way. Say, suppose he starts painting or writing poems or writing songs and all. He comes up to be a good writer and all. That is, I appreciate it. And the third, what I have seen is that they give up on themselves, right? The best part is that the second part. Channelizing your energy in a positive way. Now, when you channelize, definitely I do suggest you need to have a partner with whom you can discuss the things in a better way. So, I personally believe every person should have the ability to understand other person's feeling. That is empathetic empathy, which we can say empathetic empathy is all about. I'm trying to help you. How? By understanding your feelings. Without understanding your feelings, I cannot help you out. Yeah, it is not possible to take you out from that condition, right? So empathetic empathy is very necessary and every human being should focus on that, right? So, and that particular person whosoever has suffered should get into and should talk. If not, they can come to persons like us, psychotherapists. We are here, we can help you out in doing this, we can help you out in channelizing the energy in a positive way. Right, so that is a very crucial period, and channelize your energy as far as possible in a positive way. The second point, okay, and talk to your near and dear ones. And somehow or other, in this case, I must say, with the parents, has got a bigger role and responsibility. Yeah, they need to be the good friends. They need to be the good friends of their child, so that they feel secure. Oh my God, my parents are there behind and like safe, because. You cannot say, you cannot blame your child. You have fallen, I have asked you not to fall in love, why you did this. Once you start retaliating, he will go back from your head. When he needs support, please, parents, forgive your child. Be there for them, right? And then with the friends, they must always be there. Talk to in a proper way, channelize. It takes time. Healing takes time, but if the healing process is done in a proper way, oh my God, his parts like anything. Yeah.
So there are parts of going for healing process.
Yeah.
And what you have just pointed out, it is actually very true. And we, coming from the Indian society, we are lacking at that certain point that whenever a girl or a boy in a family goes through that breakup or something, families are usually the one opposing at that
exactly.
kind of time. Like, it was your fault, you did this, we told you not to do this. So yes, to all the parents out there, it is very important for you to support your child, let him feel that you are always there for him.
Exactly. Yeah. And we need to be open-minded, we need to talk it, because these are certain kind of emotions, and we need to be open about it. Falling in love is okay, having sex with somebody is also okay, but you have fallen in love, you had sex with somebody, but it should not get into addiction or something like that. But we need to be cautious while making intimate relationship with somebody, physical relationship with somebody, we need to be cautious. And such education should be provided and should be given in every colleges. Every colleges, I say that right from class 8 even, they should be given proper knowledge and they should be educated what exactly sex is, sexual education, so that like improper things never happens. That is what I believe, and things should be transparent, and we need to talk it in a proper way, right?
But yes, that is one of the issues with the current school curriculum too, because no proper sex education is.
Exactly.
And that's, I think it is my personal view. I think because of that, the young girls and boys, they end up being experimenting.
Exactly. Yeah, very true. Very true.
And yes, you feel? Do you feel like, because I have seen, because Netflix is on trend, there is like certain series which portray this kind of like image. But do you think that the Indian society in general is ready, they are ready to accept such changes from the Western mentality?
See, somehow or the other, nowadays the things are changing, but we need to give a proper why. See, this is completely a transition stage, what I believe. The students nowadays, they are seeing the Western culture, Indian culture, and they are getting messed up. Like, which one to follow? They find like Indian culture is, oh my god, so much of boundaries, so much of responsibility. Like, oh my god, Western culture is so good. But with the consequences also, we need to aware. We need to train the minds of the young about the consequences of everything. In spite of that, if somebody goes and does the experiments, that is a different issue. But yeah, the people do have the curiosity of everything. You cannot stop anybody. But what I do suggest, please be careful with the age group of, I say, 20 to 26, with the age group, I must say, please be careful, or even with the 18 as well. Do not go and just get into certain kind of experiments, right? This might turn into something very bad, right? And yeah, transparency should be there. What I suggest is that from Western culture, if I say, the one thing that I will pick up is that we need to be very open with our children. Let's stop everything with our children. Being a parent, we should not feel shy. Oh my god, this is coming. Let's not talk about this. Oh my god, this
it actually generally happens with watching TV.
Yeah, it's
suddenly
right.
Something comes up and it's okay.
And it creates curiosity. Oh my god, what is there? Right? Oh my god, what is there? We need to talk about it. It is a certain kind of emotions, positive emotions. But if we do not know how to use the emotions in a proper way, that turns into a very negative way as well.
So, the expert opinion again. Be open-minded, be liberal, because it is high time right now.
Exactly.
We have to manage our culture, we have to manage our boundaries, but at the same time, we should also keep up with the world. So it is not a bad thing to accept the Western culture.
Exactly.
But we have to be in certain kind of limitations.
Yeah, they also have various good things we can adopt there. Whatever we have, the various good things we have to take it. But apart from that, whatever habits we have in our Indian culture, we need to stick to it, right? We need to stick to it, and we need to transfer that to our next generation as well. So now here what I am focusing is, we need to give our child space so that they can speak openly without any fear. Speak up openly without any fear, they can express themselves.